Think so. I was just gonna say that it seems like there's a lot of pain involved when you're
meditating.
Like not meditating. I feel like sort of the isolated. I
mean, yes, you do.
You know, and it seems like there's a lot of, there's a significant amount of pain involved. Not bad pain. But,
yes.
But
isolation.
You know what I mean? Like
yes.
Sort of I don't know if it's a searching or something inside, but it's.
Well, you're not compatible with the things that people do anymore.
Yeah.
So they think they look at you, they can see you looking at them, they can see that you found a space that's not theirs, and you're looking each other across a big chasm, right?
Yeah.
You know, them in their hell and you in your heaven, because basically you are in a heaven state. See, you're basically in this objective state where you're not involved with your feelings and not involved with your emotions and reacting to things. Then people can't get to you. They can't get inside you. They can't have their way with you. Don't have any use for you if you don't respond to them and if they can't act through you. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I do.
And then you can't also, by the same token, you can't, if you're not involved with each other, you can't counteract and also have some advantage. See? In other words, when there's no emotional bond between people, there's no way that any person who is of the wrong caliber can have any advantage of you at all. For instance, if you were married and you suddenly, as a man, you would suddenly find yourself a little bit more distant and objective, having learned your lesson by involving yourself with feminine pulpitude or whatever they call it, you know, feminine charms, and having got too emotionally close to a woman where she has got inside you and is able to take liberties. Huh? You understand that, don't you? But if you ever found that to be the truth and you pull back, and you found yourself involved with the right spirit, subject to the spirit of God rather than subject to the spirit of the woman, then you might find that particular woman very disturbed, see, and angry with you and telling you that you have no feeling and no love, and trying to make you feel guilty about being detached, somewhat aloof and businesslike, you see? Because her spirit would not be able to have an advantage over you. Oh, there are other women that would love that. They would admire that quality in a man and quickly seek to dialogue with this new found strength. See? So that she might also be detached, but this time detached from her own feminine identity, like the witch identity that's lurking inside, that that tries to keep men from becoming objective. See? See? So you will find that the world itself is going to think you're cold and crazy, and they will think that you're crazy for seeing them. They'll sense that you're looking at them because you have a look that awakens. Don't you have a feeling when you listen to my program that it's almost like shocking? Not only the things I say, it's the tone. Is the ambience, isn't it, of what I'm saying? So you, as you grow, you're going to become very powerful. And you're going to be powerful not only with good people, but you'll be powerful over bad people. You'll be powerful with good people. You know, it'll be a good power, because the power will always be to help them to their higher good. But the power will be over the bad ones. Isn't that what we want in meditation? It's not an egotistical power. They just can't touch you. And the more they try to hurt you, the more they end up hurting themselves. They end up stinging themselves to death like a scorpion.
I know what you mean.
See?
Yeah.
They can't poison you, and the poison stays within them. And all they have to do is stop trying to poison you, and the poison won't accumulate within them. And you see, you won't have to try to hurt people. But we're getting a little bit away from the meditation. We're getting more into the philosophy. Are there any more questions?